Hello, we are discussing about GATE 1992 ECE paper and the topic is related to digital circuits. Look at the diagram shown. The initial contents of the 4-bit serial in parallel out right shift register shown in the figure is 0110. Initial contents of 4-bit serial in parallel outs SIPO right shift register contents are 0110. After 3 clock pulses are applied, the contents of the shift register are. What will be the contents of shift register after application of 3 clock pulses? There are 4 possibilities are given, A, B, C, D. Which will be the right answer? Okay, this is 4-bit, so that we can think it is going to be Q3. This is, assume that one it is Q2, this is Q1 and it is Q0. So this is 4-bit shift register and we are going with each flip-flop is named as Q3, Q2, Q1, Q0. And right shift register is nothing but the shifting is in this fashion. Okay, that is Q3 will be shifted into Q2, Q2 will be shifted into Q1, Q1 will be shifted into Q0. Okay, and the serial in, whatever you are getting serial in, is going to be shifted into Q3. This is what right shift register. So serial in, you must write. So serial in equation is nothing but serial in is decided by this XOR gate. This is XOR gate. So XOR gate with two inputs X1 and X0. Okay, even though it is connected with single input, that single input is going to be added for connected to the Q1 as well as Q0. So that it is Q1 exclusive Q0. Serial in. So we are naming it as SI for example. Serial in is nothing but Q1 exclusive Q0. Now we will go with a truth table. That is a function table. From that one we are identifying after 3 clock pulses what will be the contents of shift register. Okay, so we are going in this way. First we are going with present state. Okay, present state implies nothing but Q3, Q2, Q1, Q0. Next, data. Okay, here we are going with the data. The data implies nothing but Q1. Data is nothing but here it is serial in. Whatever serial in SI. Okay. So data we are going with. So this is SI serial in. That is Q1 exclusive Q0. And afterwards we are applying a clock pulse. So that the output contents will change only upon the clock pulse, because it is a sequential circuit and on sequential circuits outputs are going to be modified only on the clock edge occurrence. So that this is next state. Next state is nothing but again Q3 plus, Q2 plus, Q1 plus, Q0 plus. Next state is nothing but contents of the shift register after clock pulse. Okay, so now initial contents are given as, initial contents are going to be given in this way. 0110 are going to be, sorry, 0110 are going to be initial contents. If it is initial contents, by that time what is the serial in? It is going to be going into Q3 after application of clock pulse. So Q3 will be calculated first, because it is XOR gate which is a combinational circuit. It doesn't wait for the clock edge, because combinational circuit doesn't depend on the clock pulse, whose output is directly depends on the inputs presented that instant of time. So XOR gate is going to be a combinational circuit. For that one Q1, Q0, 1, 0. So the output is going to be 1. We must know XOR gate. XOR gate operation, truth table. So A, B are going to be inputs for XOR gate and Y is going to be output. By that time you will get output 1 for the dissimilar input combination. If the inputs are not same, at that time output will be 1. So for 0110 combination output will be 1 and 0011 combination output will be 0. That is what operation of XOR gate. So from this one you are only observing this one, you are only observing these two things. Remember that one, Q1 and Q0 only you are observing. You are observing only these two things. Next, so if you are applying a clock pulse, then the output next state will change according to the serial in as well as present state. If you are not applying clock pulse, at that time contents will be remain same. So let us assume first clock pulse you applied, so that serial in will go into the Q3 plus. Okay, Q3 Q3 plus implies nothing but now this 1 will be over here, and Q2 plus will be consisting of Q3, okay, and Q1 plus will be consisting of Q2, and Q0 plus will be consisting of Q1. So this is what. So simply you can think in this way, previous values are going to be 0 1 1 0, so that they are going to be shifted like this, right shift, and Q3 will be consisting of SI. Now if you are going with present state as 1 0 1 1, at that time SI value is going to be based on Q1 Q0 XOR between, so that Q1 Q0 are 1 1, so that output will be 0. So if you apply second clock pulse, this 0 will be going into Q3 plus, and this is shifted towards right, it is shifted towards right, this is shifted towards right, like this. 0101 is going to be the next state after application of two clock pulses. Now if it is present state 0101, at that time SI will be calculated based on the Q1 and Q0, XOR operation will give logic 1 at the output. And if you apply third clock pulse at that time, after application of third clock pulse, SI will be moved into Q3 plus. That is nothing but 1 you will get, and this 0 will be shifted, this 1 will be shifted, this 0 will be shifted. So 1010 is going to be the contents of shift register after application of 3 clock pulses. After application of 3 clock pulses, contents of shift register is 1010. So the right answer for this one is nothing but C. Thank you.